Right now, we're running out of time, and we're going to invite our brother Osi to come and give us the instruction from the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What a wonderful God. What a wonderful God. He has the marvelous things for us.
What a marvelous
God.
What a marvelous.
He's yet to do marvelous things again.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Zili bradi lagusha manse kritia. Sola bradi legiske. Bali de gris kovra di lagisha fractis. Eliman de gredias. O frate de gris o frecte gis alaman de gredias suzalitis. E brade gibos koso. O zalite gris ko frecte gibos koso manse kritias. Praise God,
praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God,
oh Lord,
praise God, praise God.
Open your mouth and bless his name. Father, we give you praise. Thank you. The one whose throne is before the city chamber. Thank you, Father, for your kindness, for your grace, for your peace. Thank you, Lord, for your strength. Thank you for your power. Maleke Christo. Mele Anda gradia brados Zuse frete limando grotos Zabratis cofrates Ele gretos cofrates Ele te gretos cofrates Ancient of days As old as you are As old as you are Say thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Say thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Say Jesus.
Jesus.
That's my boss.
That's my boss.
Say Jesus.
Jesus.
That's my boss.
That's my boss.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's pray. Father Lord, we thank you. We give you praise, adoration, majesty, and dominion. The one whose throne is before the city chambers. Oh God, teach us tonight. Reveal secrets to us. And may your name be eternally glorified in our lives. Thank you for the words you've given your son, O God. And Lord, we thank you because indeed it has come to pass for your glory. So that these ones will know that only you are God, my Father, by your Spirit. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Say, Jesus is Lord.
Jesus is Lord.
Say, Jesus is Lord.
Jesus is Lord.
Say it again. Say, Jesus is Lord.
Jesus is Lord.
Amen. For prayer and grace. Say to somebody, I love you, Jesus, much.
I love you, Jesus, much.
I love you, Jesus, much.
Amen. Take your seat. Amen. Amen. I love you, Jesus, much, sir. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Let's take Sister Ifeoma's testimony. Go ahead, ma.
The one you touched.
Yes, ma.
Asked me today to find out from you when he can baptize.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. 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 Whenever he's ready, he should let us know. Amen. So Sister Justine is in charge of our. She's in charge of sacraments, communion, baptism, all those things.
So, again about,
all right. So, Sister Justine, will you give us a
seven names.
Okay, you already have seven names. Okay, so should we do it this Saturday? This coming Saturday. Okay, we'll talk about it. We'll talk about it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. We love you all, Jesus, much. Amen.
Amen.
But Vito, come and fill in that seat. That seat there. Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
No, Sister Benedict, sit in front. Oh, okay. Praise God. Okay, sit next to him then. Sit
your apostle.
Praise God. Amen. How are you, sir?
All right.
So, we'll welcome the first timers. Please. After the lesson. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Sir, please don't sit at the back. Let's see your lovely face. Sit next to Sister Rebecca. Please, sir. Thank you so much, sir. We love you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. We like your smile. Eh? It's a smile of millions. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. How many of you have laughed today? How many of you have laughed today? It doesn't look as though you have laughed today. But you laugh now. Let's laugh.
No.
Oh yeah, let's laugh now. If you don't laugh, you will not. Amen. What did we say about? What did we say about cash? What did we say about laughter?
It brings
what? Money runs away from people that don't what? That don't laugh. So let's laugh now. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Alright, we want to today. You know, we said we want to continue on the dragon, right?
Yes.
But why sitting there? The Lord says to him, let's discuss something else. And it's so unusual the topic he wants us to discuss. Why he wants us to discuss that topic, we cannot tell. But maybe as you hear the lesson, you may be able to fill in the blanks. And maybe it has something to do with you. Because it's very, very important. The lesson that the Lord wants us to discuss is sensing evil. Sensing what?
Evil.
Sensing what?
Evil.
So you can sense evil. You can sense what?
Evil.
Respond now. You can sense what?
Evil.
Are you offended?
No.
You can sense what?
Evil.
Evil can be sensed. You can sense it. What we mean by sensing evil? You can know when evil is coming. Maybe you are driving on... We are not used to these New Jersey roads. But let's use a particular road. Apart from taking the parkway to come to this side, is there any other route again you can take to come here?
Nine. Yeah,
route what?
Nine.
Route nine. Okay. Route 35, route nine, and what? And parkway. So it is possible to be driving on route nine. Or to want to embark on a journey through Route 9. And the Spirit of God will tell you, go to Route 35. Because there is what?
An evil.
It's possible. And Route 9 and Route 35, I think there's a gap in between, right? It may not be convenient. It could be that even Route 35 may be longer, right?
Yes.
And then you begin to wonder, oh, why should I be? But the Spirit of God wants to take you out of what? Trouble. But here you are. Let's go on. And only for you to go. Bah! There was a big accident. You died. Or you didn't die. You had a terrible accident where you were rushing to, you never got there. And then they called the ambulance. God spared your life. They took you to the hospital, treated you. And then finally they came to a conclusion, they need to cut off one of the legs. Sensing what?
Evil.
It's a popular scripture. Let's look at Proverbs. And it's so interesting. We don't know why this program wants us to just share this talk with us, but let's see why. Amen. Proverbs 22 verses 3. Proverbs 22 verses what?
Three.
Are you there?
Yes.
Proverbs 22 verses what?
Three.
Sir Blessing must be familiar with that scripture. Proverbs 22 verses what?
Three.
Are you there?
Yes.
If you are there, say thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
What did he say? He said, a prudent man does what? Foreseeth the evil and does what? And hideth himself. But who? The simple pass on and they are what?
Punished.
Two kinds of men. The prudent and who?
The simple.
How many of you have heard Christians use this term? I'm just a simple person. I'm just a simple person. I'm just a simple, easygoing person.
You are looking for trouble.
That's what Satan wants to hear from you. That you're a simple man. That's the problem. Because a simple man will always be what? Punished. Look at it there. He says, a prudent man does what? Foresee. Is that not in your Bible?
Yes.
So say it now. A prudent man does what?
Foresee the evil.
He said, but a simple man does what?
Walks on.
And what?
Punished.
So a prudent man can do what? Foresee evil. Proverbs 22 verses 3. It says a prudent man does what? Foreseeth the evil. Like we told this brother earlier, don't marry in Nigeria because of what we have what?
Seen.
He said a prudent man does what? Foreseeth the evil. And a what? And what?
And hideth himself.
He goes to do what?
Hide.
Interesting that the Spirit of the Lord will use the word hide. If a man hides, what does that depict of the man? It means that he's a coward, right?
Yes.
It means that he's what? Afraid, right?
Yes.
And yet the Bible calls him what? A prudent man. So why should a prudent man do what? Hide. So you say, oh God, don't go this way. You say, what do you mean? I fear no one. I can do that. Maybe your wife says, I don't think you should go on this trip. I don't think you should talk to him. I'm going to tell you my mind. I don't take nonsense. Maybe it was an argument between you and your family member. They've been doing something. You say, no, this is it. I can't take it anymore. I'll go and talk to him. Maybe your wife is saying, please, you know these people. Leave them alone. You say, no, I was telling my mind. Who is he? And then you went to tell him your mind. 2 weeks after, you landed in the hospital. A month after, you died. You know what we're saying? Because you were telling him your what? Your mind. And in telling him or her your mind, you said things you never should have said. Listen, it is not everything you react to. You see, as we're talking to you, we know those that we're talking to. We know. Because right now there is a situation that there's somebody sitting here now. There's a step you want to take. He's serious. You are ready to damn the consequence right now. You are looking for trouble. He says a prudent man does what? Foreseeth the evil. And does what? And hideth himself. This prudent man is a diligent man. A believer. As it were, full of the Holy Ghost. Speaks in tongues. He is the prayer band leader. But the Lord says what? He does what?
He hides himself.
So the Lord says, Sister Midre, go and live in Bodley. Submitted, said, no, I want to live in East Orange, where we have my fellow Liberian folks and, you know, fellow blacks, so that if I need Maggie, I can just quickly go and say, please, can I use Maggie? Instead of, I can't go to a white woman's place to say, please, give me Maggie. So Sister Midre decided not to go to Bodley, but went to go and live in where? East Orange. And in living in East Orange, she became a victim of all manner of witchcraft. Meanwhile, the reason why the Lord was sending her to Bodley to go and live in the midst of white people was to save her from witchcraft. She went into the lion's mouth. In fact, she put her head in the lion's mouth and said, chew me. That is the problem many Christians today have. We see them. You don't know what we see sometimes that we don't talk about. Why do you think prophets were not always living in the city? Have you ever, you read the Bible, don't you have a Bible? Have you not noticed prophets, you don't always see them in public places? You don't always see them in public places. Why? Because you don't know what they see when they come out. How can Elijah, mighty Elijah who did not see death, run away from Jezebel? You think he was a coward? He says a prudent man. Foreseeth what? Evil. And does what? And that is. He didn't say foreseeth evil. He said foreseeth who? The evil. So to every man there is what? The evil. And most of you right now are already victims of some of them. A prudent man does what? Foreseeth. And you see, we always tell you, God does not leave his children in the dark. He will always give you a signal that there is something coming. Listen. Sensing evil. Say it.
Sensing evil.
Again.
Sensing evil.
Again.
Sensing evil.
Sensing evil is different from fear. They are not the same. And let's tell you the difference. Fear is something that comes from the outside. For instance, when somebody points a gun at you, you become afraid. Fear is an outside force. And the Bible does not expect us to do what? Fear. But sensing evil is not something that is coming from outside. It is coming that it is something that is coming from inside of you. Inside of you. You just know. Your spirit is not taking it. This thing. You were ready for it, prepared for it. All of a sudden, your heart couldn't take it anymore. Your heart was not ready for it. No, even though the business opportunity was big, the cash was there, but your spirit. Inside you, they say, what is wrong with you, brother Aloy? Come on now, this is what you have been praying for. God has answered your prayers now. Let's go for it. After all, brother also said, the vision is, fear is what? An outside force. But sensing evil comes from where?
From within.
How many of you know what we're talking about? You have, two of us.
True.
You have sensed evil inside of you, but you didn't know that was what you were doing. You didn't even know. Even though your boss was nasty to you, you wanted to resign, your spirit was telling you, hold on for now. Hold on. You say, I can't take it anymore. Who does she think it is? My father has businesses. So you resign. And today, you are feeding from her to man. Today you are using benefit card. At least that is the trademark you can address to yourself that you are a citizen of America. Benefit card. And the day you resign, 2 weeks after you heard that they've increased their salary, the person you even hired into the organization has now become a director. You are still there. You could not sense evil. You went to bring all your family members from America. This people was telling you, don't do it. Don't do it. Most of you don't know why we tell you, don't do it. Did your spirit give you the release to do it? Your spirit was, don't do it. You went to bed. You knew this thing was. You said, no, I must be my family member. I've started already. I've paid so much cash. I've done this. I've spent so much money. Oh, you don't know what is befalling you. What is coming. You are looking at the cash that you have already spent. Only for your sister or your auntie or your relative to come. Stay in your house. You say, let her stay before she stabilizes. Within the period she was stabilizing in your house, she stabilized very well and stabilized you out of the house. Because she did what she did, your husband does not find you attractive anymore. It is now she. And the spirit was saying, no, don't do it. Don't do it. And meanwhile, this lady is not even as fine as you. But your husband cannot see your beauty anymore. Sensing you. Your child comes and says, I want to go to Campbell. You see, your speech is not giving you the release. He said, mommy, I must go to Campbell. You say, no, go to which one? Maybe Brooklyn College. And the spirit was telling you, Brooklyn College is my way for her. He says, I must go to Campbell. Or Penn State. And then you send your child to Penn State. That was the last. So, think about those guys that they killed in Virginia. Is that college, right? Those were destinies that were wasted. Wasted by one funny, unreasonable fellow. But there was a signal in the spirit. But they were not sensitive. Think about it. If believers were not even that sensitive, is it people who are far from the civilization of the gospel? World Trade Center. You see, when you see this thing, sometimes you begin to wonder. I recall in the university, when we were in the university, we took a bus to Lagos from where our campus was. And there were three bridges. Ogun State University was the university we went to. So there were three bridges to enter the main express to Lagos. On that Sagamu route, for those who know what we're talking about. And we entered the bus at the park. We paid, I think it was 250 naira then, or 150. It was many years back. And while we sat, we like to sit at the back. We really enjoy sitting at the back. The spirit was giving us a talk. Calm down. get down from this bus. I was like, why should I get down? Many years ago. And as at this time, I was in the secret court too. I was in the secret society. But you know, my dad is a minister. I know he was born again, really, but we were in the secret court. You know, our born again there was, you know, we were trying to survive. But there was this spiritual, even though we were in the secret court, they were saying this we were spiritually minded about. Don't get this up. They were saying this. You see these people who join secret court? Have you noticed they go to church the most? Even when the pastor is preaching, they shout amen the most. You know why? They are in bondage. They want liberty. You are in liberty, but you cannot appreciate it. Calm down. Calm down. I said, man, calm down. Why should I calm down? So they said, somebody asked, are you okay? I said, I'm fine. Because they noticed I was struggling. So the bus, God filled. You know Lagos, those buses to Lagos. Because you know many of you are American, so you may not understand. But how many of you understand what those kind of buses? So, hey, Rafa, you can. You said it in Nevada, exactly. Okay. So, you know it. Sister Ifeoma, you understand? Hey, can you let you go exactly? So, we entered. The bus was full and started running. As it was going, the spoke was to get down. All of a sudden, all of a sudden, say all of a sudden.
All of a sudden.
Osi became very pressed. I said, Lord. Very pressed. I said, man, what is this? And I was sweating. You know, when somebody is that under pressure, you are sweating all over. Are you okay? I said, hey, Trevor, please stop. I want to get that. The driver, you know those Yoruba drivers? They can be very angry. Oh no, she, they were sweating. Since I have this, you know what I said? The way they said, Kilo, I've been waiting since you didn't come like this. Now, I won't give you your money. We said, go. So, you know what we're saying? He said, I won't pay you. Where? He will do it like this to us.
Yeah.
Ah! So we came down. I was angry. That was after he crossed the first bridge. So we came down. The moment we got down like this, our feet touched the ground, we were fine. I said, what is this? This is a waste. It was a waste, obviously, because I could have gotten that money back if I had listened to the voice of God's Spirit. So we came down. Still had some money. Another bus came. This bus was not full. Lagos. So he stopped. We entered. As this bus was going, we crossed the second bridge. By the time we got to the third bridge, we heard bah! The bus fell off the bridge.
Which one?
The first bus. Fell off the bridge. And the water, this was during dry season, during December period. So the rocks were, you could see the rocks. So it was bah on the rock.
No.
The people died. The driver who was saying, Oloshi, come and see him. He looked like meat. Meat. But there was one Christian sister. She was the one who even prayed inside the bus. That was the only person who survived. So she said, why didn't you tell us this bus was going to happen? We were in the bus. So we said, stop. I was inside this bus just now. I came down. So they stopped to come and help. They were dead. So this sister, she now looked at her. She said, you were the one that got down from the bus. She said, why didn't you tell us? Say sensing evil.
Sensing evil.
In other words, anticipating evil. You can anticipate when evil is coming. It's not fear, oh. It's not fear. Say it's not fear. But you can sense it from within. It's amazing. Hey, we went on our Facebook 2 days ago. One of our friends,
We went to the same school together, but she was a junior to us. We went to the same university.
We saw her wedding picture as she was signing marriage register with a white man.
She posted it on her Facebook page.
When we looked at it, we said, ah, what a blunder. We could see that this was deception. We could see this. It was too obvious.
You know, some people may not be spiritually minded. I said, why can't this girl make this blunder?
Is it by force you must marry a white man?
But she didn't know. She's married now. To her, she's happy. At least she posted it on Facebook. At least for all to see that she's what?
Married.
But she doesn't. But she doesn't know what she has what entered. She doesn't know.
Too many are not listening to the voice of God's spirit within them. They are listening to their friends. Listening to their friends. Listening to their village members. Listening to their brothers and sisters. Listening to
even a pastor who is not spiritually minded.
The one that does. See, listen. A pastor who is not your pastor cannot give you counsel. He will destroy you. A pastor is not who? Your pastor cannot give you counsel. He will destroy you. No matter how good the person is, he will destroy you. You think God was stupid when he gave you that person as a pastor? God was not stupid. Even if the pastor is not nice to you, there are certain areas he knows he cannot compromise. What good will he do him if he comes to come and do burial? Maybe there are pastors in America who find delight in organizing burial, but not for us. So. Sensing evil.
Let's show you something again. Go to Proverbs 27. Say thank you, Holy Spirit. Are you learning something?
Yes.
I hope we didn't bore you with that story. Proverbs 27. Look at verses 12. Proverbs 20 what?
7.
Verse what?
12.
What did he say again?
Foreseeth
the evil. And does what? And hired himself. The simple does what? Pass on and award. He repeats the same thing again.
That's to tell you how important it is. And it is a spiritual law when God speaks twice. It's a spiritual law. It means that thing you should take it very seriously. He uses the same words. Says the same thing word for word. He says what? A prudent man does what? Foreseeth evil. Now this was Solomon talking. Other than the guidance of the Spirit. So don't think this guy who was speaking was a fool. This was a man who had an uncommon wisdom. You say you are too wise. You cannot be talked to. You cannot be talked to. I'm a principality. I'm Christ. But also has been teaching us that nothing.
But the Spirit of God said, I know you are a principality. I was the one who even told you that you are a principality, but hold on for now.
He said, no, nothing.
So you go back. Now you are calling Brother Osi on the phone for prayers.
A man called us 2 days ago. I was telling us about his wife. Telling us everything about his life is scattered. Then the Lord said, tell me, he's very hot tempered.
We don't know that the person is even here. But we told the person, you can come to the Bible Center.
Then the Lord said, tell him he's very hot tempered. So we said, oh God, the Lord said you are very hot tempered. He said, it is true. But that is what destroyed his marriage and his life. His own anger, but he doesn't know. Now, he probably wants the wife back. Maybe. Or he wants to have a better life. But who would want to be with a hot tempered fellow? Who? Who? For the lady, it was even a relief that she left the fellow. A prudent man does what? Foresees evil. And does what? Doesn't mean you are stupid. No. Why? Why are you hiding? Because of what you have already seen. There is trouble coming. So it is not all the time you talk back to your director. It is not all the time you call out. Because there are some calling out you do in your job that will just put you in a hole for a very long time. Listen, if you can learn to listen to your spirit, must you lie all the time? You remember at the conference, there was a lady
that the Spirit of God we were ministering to her, and we said to her, Madam, this is the cause of your problem.
Yes, she was arguing.
She was arguing, right?
Yes.
What did she later say? She said,
grandfather.
No, not even that one. That's another person. A lady
called out.
She said, I don't do it.
Yeah.
But
okay.
I don't call out. But what happened?
Eventually she agreed.
She said what? She said
the
person
was once. She said she was once.
She said the person has left.
Yes.
But what did the law say? The law said it is in our records.
Yeah.
But she was arguing and she came for solution. See something. It is a prudent man does what? Foresee evil. Now, how do you foresee evil? You may want to ask.
Yes.
It begins with you, first of all, studying the word of God and learning what you should know about the things of God. Like you're doing now, right? But then, let's tell you one secret. Look up. Any person you meet for the first time, say it.
Any person you meet for the first time
is a sign to something.
He says, sign to something.
Did you
hear
what he said?
Yes.
Any person that you meet for the first time, either through a handshake or whether the person came to inquire something from you, it's a signal to something. It is whether or not you know what that signal is. Did you know this before?
No.
Go to the book of John. Let's show you something. John chapter 12. I don't know why this. We wanted to continue on our dragon series, though. I hope you are not offended, though, because.
No.
Are you sure you are not offended?
No.
Eva, you are
not. I am not.
You are always hungry for it.
Daddy, are you sure you are not offended?
Yeah.
Are you sure you are not offended? Why are you not offended, my daddy? Is this what? A prudent man does what? Foresee the evil and does what? Hides himself. He said, but the simple does what?
Go on.
The Lord is with me. I'm a principality. Hey, Baraku Shemale Greti Leva. Then he starts saying, Jesus. Bah! There was a sister at the convent in Philadelphia. Sister Tina.
Yes.
Sister Tina.
Yeah, yeah.
She called us this evening and shared the testimony
yes,
with us.
I asked her to share the testimony. She told me.
She wanted to go that afternoon.
Yes.
We said,
no.
The speaker said, tell her not to travel.
Yes.
Don't travel. So she stayed back.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God she stayed back.
Yes.
When she was telling us, she said her husband, right?
Mm-hmm.
A trailer almost
crushed him,
killed him, P16. It was a small covert that hooked the trailer for the husband to pass.
Small.
Then she said, Osi told us who? Osi told us. She just came to say, I'll see you now. Thank you for the covert. I'm going home now. I need to rush back. We said, okay, no problem. And she was going to say, call her back. Tell her not to go. Listening to the voice of the Spirit within you.
Amen.
Then we said to her, the highways are not clear.
Yeah.
Plus then the highways are not clear. You don't know you. You enter your car. You have a good car. You just really bought it. The engine is super. You can run 300 kilometers per hour. Wonderful. And then you enter. That 300 kilometers drove you to hell. You know, there's something about Brother Peter, Brother Deacon Peter Unora. He has a particular gadget in his car that if he's driving with that gadget, he can sense when there's a police,
a radar,
right?
Yeah.
And they will give him a signal.
Yes.
So, so, no matter... No, it is legal, yeah. You know, it is some other states that are illegal.
Yeah, it's legal.
You think the person who designed it was stupid? He probably, the person who designed it must have been a victim of police. But listen carefully. Doesn't mean that Rabbi Peter is afraid of the police. No. But he's trying to take what? Caution. The thing is giving him what? Because that is how your spirit is. Your spirit. You know what we're saying now? That's what we didn't want to talk about Brother Peter just to mention it. We were focusing on the way Brother Peter has a wonderful relationship with that. That's how many of you can relate what we're saying?
Yes, I know what they
are. Even in school, too. There are certain people you should sense. This one, I can't have this person for a friend. There are certain people you should sense. This one, no, not this one. Think about the things you have lost by listening to these people. We said anyone you meet is what? Is a what? Is a signal to what? To something. But it is whether or not you know what that thing is. Including nothing that you met. It was a signal to something. And this is it. Right? But how about the other people you meet every day of your life? That's why the Bible says, for to be carnally minded is death. Yes. Romans chapter 8, verse 6. He says, if you are carnally minded, you will just die. You will live like a chicken. To be carnally minded is to be simple minded. Romans chapter 8, verse 6. Carnally minded means you are controlled by what you see, what you hear, how you feel, how you taste. And what you smell. That's what it means to be carnally minded. And a Christian is not supposed to be that way. There is what you call the sixth sense. It's inside of you. That's the person to trust. Because these ones will deceive you. Have you not seen? When we first came to America, we went into an American Italian cuisine. It was on our birthday. The pastor who lived it wanted to celebrate the birthday with us. So he ordered for Italian cuisine. We saw their delicacy, saw the menu, woo, the pictures of the food. Man, I said, I will eat today. I will eat American food. We just came to America. Few days, I think like a week. That's how they brought the food. I saw one sister, interestingly, at the next table, the way she was eating, enjoying what she was. I said, I would like to eat that. Oh, we didn't know that was trouble. They want to bring it to only for us to take, have a taste, and we shouted, what is this? And the pastor was laughing. He said, Lucy, I was telling you. I said, Pastor, is this what this lady was eating just now that I was saying? What am I trying to say? What are we trying to say to you? We were moved by what? What we saw and what we smelled. We perceived the aroma. Oh. How many of you have seen bitter leaf soup? Bitter leaf soup. Does it look fine to you?
No.
But it's tasty, right?
Yes.
Or banga?
Original.
What was that thing you gave us that day that we took home?
Isewu.
That thing does not look fine at all when you look at it. But eat it, brother. You'll be born again. At least the glorious anointing is special. But the point is, when you are moved by what you see, what you hear, how you feel, what you taste, and what you smell, you are finished. That's all Satan needs from you. So you saw this guy, six pack, nice Italian shirt, lovely perfume. So you say, this is the guy. Not knowing you were marrying a beast. Your honeymoon, the first gift he gave you was a slap.
Oh, you're already married.
Sometimes, have you not noticed some beautiful ladies who marry some ugly men, but they are happy?
Yes.
Have you not noticed?
Yes.
You begin to wonder, what is she doing in this marriage? Look at this brother. Look, he has a big nose. He's not very fine. But the sister is happy. Because that fine brother. Here
you want, sister XYZ want to marry a tall, fine brother. But she cannot work with the brother. They cannot even wear the same uniform. It's either the brother is at the back, she's in front. Or the brother is in front, she's at the back. You know what we're saying. Maybe things are better now. Thank God things are better now. But it was not like that before, remember? John chapter 12. Say thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
This was after Jesus rose Lazarus from the dead in chapter 11. So now in chapter 12, we want to show you something that happened to Jesus. Because the fame of Jesus had gone around the region that he brought Lazarus back to life. And as a matter of fact, the Pharisees wanted to kill Lazarus that Jesus brought back to life. But see something in chapter 12. Are you there in chapter 12?
Yes.
Go to verses 20 now. Let's read from verses 19. Let's read from verses 18. It says, "For this cause the people also met him, for that they heard that he had done this miracle. The Pharisees therefore said among themselves, Perceive ye how ye prevail nothing. Behold, the world is gone after him." You see, people ran after Jesus. Because you see, people go to where there is solution. Two of us. Abby? People have real problems, right?
Yeah.
They want real solutions.
Yes.
And so they go for real solutions, like Brother Aloy will always say, right? Amen. So people ran after Jesus. The Pharisees could not give them solution, right? So they went after Jesus. And they saw Jesus before their very eyes bring a four days old dead body back to life. Somebody who has been embalmed, his intestines, everything had been removed. Embalmed, and Jesus called the person back to life. They said, "Man, this is the guy, yo. This is it." And they went, verses 20 now. The Pharisees, verses 19, said among themselves, "Perceive ye how ye prevail nothing. Behold, the world is gone after who?" After who?
Yeah.
Now, verse 20. "And there were who? Certain Greeks among them that came up to worship at where?
At
the feast." What did they do? He said, "The same came therefore to who?
Philip,
which was of Bethsaida of Galilee, and desired him, saying, Sir, we would who? We will see Jesus." In other words, they said, "Sir, please, we would like to see Jesus." Who came? Certain Greeks. Who came to worship? They came afterwards and said they wanted to see who?
Jesus.
Let's see what happened. Verse 22. "Philip cometh and telleth Andrew. And again, Andrew and Philip telleth Jesus. And Jesus said unto them, saying, The hour is come that the Son of Man should be what?
Glorified."
Think about that. They came to tell him that there were people waiting for him. Who came to see him? He said, "Now it is time for me to be glorified. That means it is time for me now to die." So the coming of these Greeks was a signal to Jesus. But the disciples who were with Jesus didn't even know it. They didn't know it. Who came to see you that brought you the signal that you did not know? Who came to see you? Who came to see you? Who came to do what? See you. Who came to look for you? Who did you receive into your house? It was a signal to something, but you did not know. You did not know. It was a signal to something. These Greeks, when you read down, Jesus never saw them. Those people waited. Even Philip and Andrew were surprised. Master, some people are waiting. Some fellows are waiting. Jesus said, he now started preaching to them. Because one time when they came to kill Jesus, what did Jesus do? He escaped.
Yes.
One time he disappeared. Now Greeks came to see him. They didn't come to look fight him. They just wanted to see him. He said,
It is not time for me to die. Only God knows how many times he has been giving you the signal. By the people he has brought to your life. But you were not sensitive. You were just too dull of hearing. Because you were never told. You didn't even know. So I said, how can adults like you be coming to listen to one small boy called Osi, travel all the way from Union, Bodley, come to look for one small boy Osi? All in the name of saying he is a preacher. But you don't know what Osi knows. And you don't know what these people are benefiting. That is why you have a problem. The people came to see who? Jesus. Jesus said, it is time. It is time for me to be glorified. Let's even read it again. Verse 23. Verse 22. Philip cometh and telleth Andrew. And again, Andrew and Philip telleth who? Jesus. And Jesus answered them, saying, the hour is come that the Son of Man should be what? Glorified. Then he says, verse 24. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. He that loveth his life shall lose it, and he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it unto life eternal. And if any man serve me, let him follow me, and where I am, there shall also my servant be. If any man serve me, him will my Father do what?
Honor.
Look at verse 27. He said what?
Now.
What's the first word there?
Now.
What's the first word?
Now.
What's the first word?
Now.
What did he say now is now? Now is my spirit
troubled.
Now is my what?
Spirit.
He was never troubled. At all. But the very moment he was told, certain Greeks were looking for him, who came to visit him, he said, my spirit is troubled. Somebody brought you a signal. You were dull to know that it was time. But you didn't know. You probably didn't even know whether it was time for what. Jesus, he said, now is my what? Spirit troubled. And the disciple, he said it to them. And Andrew and Philip were like, what is the matter? Who is troubling him? Is it because you came to tell him certain people are looking for him? Hey. Listen, it is not every invitation you should honor. It is my friend, we are doing wedding. Ah, we went to school together. Ah, she was always there. So you went for her wedding. And when you got to the venue, you stepped on something. And now you have elephantiasis. But the Spirit was saying, don't go, don't go, don't go, don't go. He says now, verses 27. What did he say? Is my what? Spirit troubled. What shall I say? Father. Do what? Save me from what?
This hour.
This. He was specific. This hour. What is your hour? What is your hour? Because trouble will surely come. What are you going to do? He was prepared. You see, that was why Jesus was never taken on away. Somebody said because he was the Son of God. Not true. That's the reason it has been written for us in the scriptures, for us to learn and follow. The Bible says, for as Jesus is, so are we in this world. There is no child of God who has the Holy Ghost that God will ever leave in the dark. He has always been giving you signals. It is whether or not you were attentive. He started praying, Father, save me from this hour. Verse 28, he said, Father, glorify thy name. Then came there a voice from heaven saying, I have both glorified it and will glorify it again. So if he had not said what he said, he wouldn't have heard the voice. How many times the Spirit of God gave you a signal by the people he brought to your life to tell you it is time to make progress? You were still looking at your friend, waiting on your friend. Sister Mary, now let's do this thing now, this and that.
And do you know, Dr. D.K. Olukoya once made a statement. He had a class one day he taught. And he taught on a message titled, Time Wasters. There are people who have come to this world, life, to just come and waste people's time. It's what they came to do in life. And many of you are friends of them, friends to them. And they are wasting your time. Ever since you've had these people as friends, you cannot really say that you have made meaningful progress. So you spend 7 months with them, and that 7 months, nothing to show for it. Nothing. Rather, your life went in a reverse. Time wasters. And every good plan you had, you shared with them, and it never materialized. But both of you go to church. Both of you are in the same prayer bar. You speak in tongues. Listen, the Bible says, Jesus said, he said, the kingdom of God is like a man who had a field and sowed good seeds. What did Jesus say? He said, but while men slept, the enemy came and did what?
And
sowed tears. On that same day that the seeds were, that the good seeds were sown. Then, after the seeds sprang up, the Bible says the people were surprised. Master, look at tears. What did Jesus say? He says, an enemy. He said, while men slept, an enemy did what? Did this. So when did you sleep in your life? We're not talking about going to bed to sleep. No, when did you say, this time around, I just want to take some time off? When did you take time off? Probably that was the time calamity struck. So you went to do LPN or CRA or CNN. Because everybody is doing it. Exam, you cannot pass. A sister called up for her exams. That her computer went off when she was writing the exam. So this and that. She called up for prayers. So we told her, they will give you an opportunity to write the exam again. You know Sister Gloria.
Yes.
So we prayed. The day we prayed, we said, okay, what day are you going? She said, Monday morning. So we said, okay, go. She went on Monday morning. The director said, hold on for now, but just keep praying. So we said, madam. She now called us again. I said, madam, you will write your exam. They told you to hold. So she got back. They told her they would give her the exam. Careful. She got back home. A classmate called her and said her name was not on the list. So she didn't pass. That means she has to repeat the class. So guess what? She carried the phone again and called Brother Alson. So we said, madam, what is wrong with you? What is your own name? She said, my name is so-so-so. What is your friend's name? So-so. Do both of you have the same destiny?
No.